Right, so welcome to, well, it was the IFMAR 110th IC Track World Championships. It is now the IFMAR Hoverboat RC World Championships because the rain has come in. You may have noticed. I kind of noticed as well, as has our cameraman. So just to clarify some of the procedures and what's going to happen next now as we wait for the weather to subside, we have Dallas Matheson here from EFRA and IFMAR. You're kind of wearing two shirts this weekend. So, Dallas, just tell us, well, obviously we have to wait for the track to dry first. What will the procedure be after that for kind of getting qualifying restarted?
I think we will try to start with round three and in the middle try to squeeze in the last round again if the track is dry enough. Try to find the same condition, build up some traction on the track and things like that, and then continue.
Yeah, because of course the issue with, we got to the last round of round two, but obviously it has to take place on a track that's similar conditions, so there's the issue.
Yeah, correct.
So
that's why we are trying to start with round three, have a small break or squeeze in the last round in the middle of it if we get the same condition on the track.
And the just confirm for us, the official procedure is that a minimum of two rounds of qualifying have to be completed for it to be official, correct?
I think it's even one, to be honest, but I'm not 100% sure.
It may have to be one if it continues like this, but I heard it was two, but it may only be one, which will make things very interesting. Just how different is this going to make the whole complexation of this event, given that people have been practicing on this track for the last week and now it's going to completely change?
Yep. Of course, it will have some effect on the result. You see, the last heat was the only one making 19 laps. So I doubt it will be possible to make 19 laps again right now. But let's see. Might be they also try to squeeze in another round tomorrow.
Yeah, that's very true. You might still be able to complete those laps of qualifying tomorrow. Just how late into the day can we afford to run track action today in terms of trying to squeeze in action late? There is literally lightning right above us. This is spectacular. I feel like I'm doing a nature documentary as well, but just how late in the day can we, like, when is the cutoff for engines to be shut down for the day here?
When it's dark.
Literally, as soon as the sun comes down, that is it. So that is pretty much, it will literally be all hands to the pump to try and get rounds in today.
Yeah.
That's excellent. Well, we wouldn't expect anything less from IFMAR and EFRA. They've run a very tight ship so far this weekend. This is unfortunate, but we will be able to progress through. There's no... Are you still feeling confident we'll be able to complete qualifying and the rest of the event?
I hope so, yeah.
Hope? he's kind of like us now. We're kind of cynical in the British weather kind of way, so I can kind of understand that. He's got his brolly. He's well prepared. I don't even have a brolly. So we're just going to have to make the dash through to the pits.
Yeah, go ahead.
Make the run for it if we can.
Yeah, have to run for it. Yeah.
I'm going to have to do my Usain Bolt impression. Thanks very much, Dallas, for speaking to us. Some other of the officials as well. There is the smallest gap. And get ready, John. Run. We made it. We're here. We're in the pits. Everyone is bundled under the covers here. You can hear the racket. I can barely hear myself talk here. But one guy who is still here, pretty under the covers, is Andy Moore, the Brit, the former electric touring car champion. Andy.
You look a bit wet.
Really? You noticed? You're looking annoyingly dry.
I am, yeah.
I guess you just, well, you were already undercover, but I guess, when the rain came in.
Yeah, it just started to rain. I was about to go out to Marshall, just after our run, and the rain came down, so.
So you were just waiting there like, I'm going to give that a second. That was a good idea. Yep. But how kind of frustrating is it, given that we made it so much of the way through round two, but then the final heat got lost?
I mean, it is annoying. I don't know exactly what their plan is to do now, because I think they say we continue if the conditions get back to similar, but they're probably not going to get back to the same, so I guess they'll cancel the round. So overall, it doesn't really make any difference, because then it's the same for everybody. They just cancel everything and that's it.
Just call a reset, basically. Go straight into round three, I guess. So how does this change your plan in terms of setup? Because effectively, the track is now going to be completely different to the one that you've driven and practiced on for the last few days.
Yeah, to be honest, I mean, I've got no idea what it's going to be like. I don't know. Yeah, I guess it's going to be a lot less traction, but it's the same for everybody. So just see what happens, yeah.
It's pretty level in there. We're now having thunder above us. What I think is interesting as well, I think we can see this on the back there, on the back windows. There's actually water coming down and affecting some of the tables near to the side. You're in a pretty good position here. You look okay. The car looks pretty dry.
I'm pretty lucky to be at least on this side of our table, because these guys are on the limit. But we're all right in here. So.
All got a bandy together, I guess. So the official procedure we've just been told is that we at least need one round of qualifying. We have that. Were you happy with the one round of qualifying that you completed?
Not too bad. I mean, I won heat 12, and then there was seven guys in front of me in the one before, so I finished 8th overall. So it's all right. Yeah, to start with, it's a banker. Some guys don't have anything yet, so we'll see what happens. I think the weather forecast for tomorrow is looking better now. So if we don't get to run today, at least some more running tomorrow, I think.
Yeah, I think so. And the way the rain is, it's actually coming down even harder, if anything. It really is going to be a challenge to get this thing dry. I mean, you were there in Sweden with us. A 20-minute shower took about 2 hours to clear over, and now we've got a burst water main over here. It's all action. This is quite something. I couldn't believe this. This is we'll leave you to stay in the dry under here, and hopefully we'll see you out on track at some point later in the event. Cheers. Well, there's Andy, one of the British contingent we just had a word with. So. One guy staying merry in amongst the chaos. But now who have we got here?
Kyle Branson.
Kyle, good to speak to you. Another one of the British contingent here. I bet you must have thought, like me, we'd left this summer behind when we flew to Italy.
Yeah, I know. It actually rained a little bit earlier in the week as well, but not like this. This is pretty bad.
just a little bit. There was even a burst kind of water pipe over there, which was quite incredible. But let's talk about the on-track action if we can. There's not much at the moment, obviously, but of the sessions that you've done so far, how are you feeling about your car and your setup?
The first 2 days of practice were really good. Was sixth overall after the first day and third on the second. And then the track changed a lot when everybody else come and did more running, and it also got hotter. So I was trying to find another setup, and I never really found it until like a couple of runs ago. The last run of qualifying then was really good, but I think I TQ'd the round so far before the top heat went out, but obviously it just rained, so I think they're going to cancel that round now. So,
which must be pretty frustrating. You've just got a good run in the book. And what must be more difficult now is effectively this is going to wash the track clean. How do you anticipate changing the setup to try and keep up with it? Now it's effectively back to square one.
I mean, you've just got to go out there. I mean, I'd hope they'd open the track for some sort of practice for maybe 1 hour, just try and get the track back up to the condition it was at. But yeah, you just got to try and judge it as you hope you think it's going to be, I guess. Because because how heavy it is. If it's just light rain, normally it's okay. You go back out and the lap times are pretty much identical. Because obviously the heavy rains took all the foam out of the surface, and it's going to wash it all over the track. So I'm sure the track's going to be for when we first go out.
It's going to be very tricky. Do you anticipate we'll get any more running in today?
I don't know. I mean, now it's like, nearly 3 o'clock, and it's forecast for the rest of the day. So I don't think so.
We're not feeling optimistic, I don't think. Well, let's move on to the rest of the event. Let's assume, I mean, the forecast tomorrow is better. Let's hope it is. But going forward, I mean, what you've got on the track so far, how confident do you feel of getting a good result out of this World Championship?
After the last run, fairly good. But then when I seen the rain, maybe not, because the first run was pretty bad as I crashed. So that was one round gone. And I knew it was forecast rain, so I thought, well, you know, that's not ideal. But the last run was really good, so I was hoping to keep it, but it looks like it's not going to go that way. That's just the way it goes sometimes. So
yeah, it is unfortunate in that respect, but still feeling confident, keeping spirits up under here, keeping relatively dry. I notice you've budged everyone up.
He's been on the end.
Yeah, I feel for those guys on the end. You can just see it, they're dribbling down the side, but you're in the right place, undercover. This is what happens when you just go outside in these conditions for about 10 seconds. Yeah, pretty much. These shirts are not waterproof, but thank you very much for talking to us.
Thanks very much.
Good luck for the rest of the event. Cross your fingers as well. Right, who else do we have in here? We have everyone kind of bunched into the middle, so it's more compacted than ever, this pit area. Everyone sort of squeezed in a real sort of intense, everyone sort of budged in from the sides. to avoid any rain coming down. We've got Bruno Coelho just there. We're just popping around. I think he's just moved away. There he is. Yes, he heard me say his name. Right. Mr. Coelho.
Hello.
Hello. Sorry for bringing the weather.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
We were hoping to leave it behind in England when we came to Italy, but unfortunately that's not the case. Now, let's have a talk about this. So far, the cars look very good. You are, of course, coming in here as the reigning European champion in this discipline. How kind of confident have you been feeling? People are squeezing past us here. How confident have you been feeling going into this event of getting a good result here?
Yeah, that's true. The car was getting much better than in the beginning of the week. Beginning of the week was very difficult to drive the car here and was difficult to get fast. But now it's pretty good, the car. And I was fighting for the TQ last round, but a mistake in last lap was a little bit bad. But I think I'm confident.
How frustrating was it? Because it literally, the heavens opened just as you guys were about to go out for your second run. Just how frustrating was it up there?
Yeah, for sure it was, because everybody was screaming for the restroom upstairs, like last lap. And I know I was fighting for the TQ, so I just forced too much the car, and I just made a mistake.
It's a real shame. It literally was just as the heavens opened up, and it probably means round two is going to be a wash, no pun intended. The bigger challenge now, of course, is that the track is going to largely be very different to the one you've practiced and qualified on so far. How do you anticipate making changes to the car to effectively go out on a brand new surface?
I think, to be honest, I think I will not change nothing on the car, because we don't practice like this. We never know when rain, if it changes too much the track or not, or if now is even better than before. We don't know. So I will wait and I will make the second qualified. I don't know. I will arrive and I will check if it's okay or not.
So you're kind of going to take a kind of reactionary approach, you know, go out there, get some laps and then see what to do.
Yeah, that's it.
Sounds like a very smart approach, actually. So they're saying that the forecast will be better for the next few days. Let's hope so. Let's move on past qualifying. How confident are you of adding a world championship to that European crown?
To be honest, it's a surprise how it is working now, because I don't practice so much the nitro class, only in electric class. On road, so for me it's a surprise that the car is working so well, and also my performance is very good now. So I think for me, for sure, I have a chance to win. I think everybody has a chance, but my car is very good, and also the engine is working very good. So I mean, I have good possibilities.
There's every chance. And just one more question: do you think it's a washout for the rest of the day?
You think? Sorry.
Do you think it's a washout for the rest? Do you think we're going to get any more racing out there today?
Today, I don't think so.
So we'll reset for tomorrow by the looks of it. It looks fairly likely, but it has stopped again. It may just give us a window to dry it. We'll see. Either way, thank you very much, Bruno, for talking to us. Good luck for the rest of the event. Right, I think Frank's found someone else. Oh. Alex Hagberg. Well, we have the reigning champion of this event now up. Alex, I don't know if this... Does this weather, in a weird way, does this weather actually kind of help you? Because so far it feels like something's not been quite right with the pace of the car.
No, I have been off pace clearly throughout practice and still working on finding the right setup of the car. So I don't know if the track condition will change enough for me to improve, maybe. We'll see.
It will be, with this amount of rain, it'll probably wash a lot of the put down on the track and a lot of the compound off. Do you kind of anticipate to make changes to expect that, or do you kind of go out there and then see how the track has changed?
I think we have to watch the first few heats that run on the track to see how it has changed. I assume traction will be a bit lower after the rain. Yeah.
So what has been your biggest issue so far that you've been struggling with in the car, and how have you been trying to fix it?
I've been struggling to find steering in the car, mainly in the hot condition, and whenever we build steering in the car, it's been too hard to drive. So still working on the overall balance of the setup.
Which has probably been a very difficult balance to strike, given it's quite a fast circuit. It's a very intense little circuit. But going forward, let's hope we get through qualifying. No more rain delays. How confident are you of getting the setup on point and going back to back in this World Championship?
Yeah, there's still time to improve the package, and we'll see. But I'm still hopeful.
Good to hear. Nothing, you'd expect nothing less from the reigning champion of this event. Alexander, thanks very much for talking to us. Best of luck for the rest of the event. So still having a look round. A lot of guys have made a run for cover and for warmer climbs. Oh, sorry. Squeeze through. Just having a look round. See if we recognise anybody. See if there's anyone tucked through at the back end of the pit. And let's just have a wander down here. This is the main pit area we've just come through. Have a look out there. The clouds are still very grey. And up here, there's going no one on it at the moment. But let's have a quick look at the driver's rostrum. Now, this was the area where all the drivers before were literally stood here, about to go out for their top heat, and then the rain came down. So, but this is the driver's eye view, as you can see. If you look off to the right, there's the first few turns. There's the Shepherd S right there. And this is effectively the view the drivers get. A lovely slow pan across. And these guys get the best possible view. You can see the building we've been in the whole time with the scoreboard. And it was just, it's actually, the scoreboard has stopped on just where the next heat was going to go out, which included Dario Balestri, who we're going to see if we can try and find. Bearing in mind, a lot of guys are starting to pack up, assuming that this is the end of play for today, or they're waiting around. We'll have a look around, we'll see who we can find. This is the driver's rostrum anyway. This is where they drive their cars from. It's where all the action happens. Let's see if we can move down to this end of the pits. See if there's any more we can find. This is the back area of the kind of pit control area. There's one of the marshal posts just there. You can see those race seats have been dragged in quickly and through to the back area of the pits. There's a mechanics area. That's where last minute tweaks are made before the start of a heat. And this pit area is also fairly deserted as well. This is what's to expect. This will be the Japanese, the Philippines, and the Thai end of the pits as well. I think the US section. It's kind of grouped in nationalities that way as well. See if we can sneak down here a little bit just to see out onto the track. I just want to see if I can show you the level of water on the track. It is still raining. I won't make Jan walk back out there. I think you can see it just in the exit of pit exit there. Look at how much standing water there is. That's an incredible amount. And then going into the first turns, you can see it all kind of mounting up in the guttering and the rumble strips on the inside. It's I'm wary being dribbled on, but I guess at this point it barely matters. It is drizzling a little bit, but at this point I don't care. We're already mildly wet. There's the first turns, and there's the speedometer. There's the speed trap. A nice close-up look at that. Stuck on 940 kilometers an hour. I think it's just trolling us at this point because we're doing zero. Hang on. Can I trip the speedo? Oh, it's got to be worth it. Where's the speed trap? I want to see. I can trip the speed trap. Is it there? I'm wondering. Walking. Come on. I wonder if it's immune to walking. And maybe I was expecting it to come up with like 0.3. Maybe it just doesn't measure in how slow I'm walking. let's pop over here as well. Let's have a look around the track. As I say, it's just drizzling now. We've already been rained on, so me and Jan just don't care at this point. Through the runner time fuel turns. This is the fast first sweep. Well, it's not very fast at the moment, but this is the fast first sweeper coming into this corner here, the second of the runner time turns. And there's your hairpin, and there's an indication here. Let's have a look here. Right down here on the surface, there's your standing water right there. That's what the people are going to have to deal with the most when they're drying this track off. It's not necessarily just dampness, it's squeezing that off, because even on rain tires on full scale cars, there's no grip in that. There just isn't anything. So that's going to be the biggest issue here as we move through to the back area. This is the sort of dining area and the relaxation area, which people are going to be taking advantage of. Hey, how you doing? Keeping the spirits up, they're getting the beers in. That's not a bad strategy, actually. Strong beers, yeah. But let's move through here. Have a look and see if we can find any familiar faces massing around here. I mean, it's undercover, so that's about as good as anywhere at the moment. The food queue is also pretty long. I think we're going to have to join it at some point. We're in the restaurant area. There's some more of the catering through there. Just have a look around the facilities of this track. It's a very well-equipped track, this one. A lot of facilities here. So let's have a look up here. I'm particularly interested to see, as the guys are going to be doing that out on track quite a bit. And yeah, let's have a look up here. There's the bar. I think people are going to need quite a lot of use of that by the end of this. There's the DJ table. There was some DJ music Some nice music playing out after the conclusion of practice yesterday, and I'm pretty sure that'll be the same way again. This is the relaxation, the kind of VIP area, chilling out for us. Our work's never done. These guys, when the rain comes in, they're relaxed. The most important part, the table football.
Queen of Country. Australia,
yes.
Australia.
Ah.
Australia.
Honorary. Well, this Australian British ref. Oh, okay. Oh, well, we were gonna watch you play. I won.
9-3. These guys have a table at home. I just have to say.
Of course. Is that your race driver's excuses coming out?
It's the equipment. Hello, Australia.
Hey.
Caveman. Hello. Who else is watching? I know. Josh.
Mate, they'll all be sleeping back in Australia.
Bonjour la France. Yeah.
Hey.
Let's go.
So are you guys anticipating any more track action today?
No.
Yes.
No, absolutely not.
I think no.
Football.
I really hope so, because it might put me quite a lot higher if I get the second round.
So that's two, no, that's one yes, three no's, one I hope so. Not really the most optimistic, but hey, we'll let you get on with your game, fellas. Enjoy the rest of your day. Hopefully we'll get some more running out of this one. And well, I think we're going to bring this one to a close now. We've pretty much been the length and breadth of this track. We've seen plenty of people. We spoke to plenty of the drivers. It's been good to get their perspective on what is now a difficult period in the event. No one ever likes a rain delay, but you've seen how some of the guys are spending the time now and just easing it down. Not much positivity on this. This thing's going to get restarted, but we're still going to be here the whole time. If anyone, if anything comes out on this track that isn't water or sponges, we'll be there to cover it. Race cars hit this track again, we'll be there to cover it for you. In the meantime, keep it locked to RC Racing TV from the IFMAR 110th IC Track World Championships 2016. Yeah, welcome back, folks, on RC Racing TV. As you can see out the windows, the situation has, in fact, it's if anything got worse. There's more thunder, there's more lightning, there's more rain, and there's more just meh. It's been one of those days, folks, and we were expecting a decision on whether there'll be any more driving, any more running today. I think Mother Nature's made that decision for us. I'd be absolutely stunned if anything else happens today, but thankfully for you, we have more stuff to show you, because we had that first pit walk just then. We went and filmed another one, and we had a chat with plenty of the biggest names out here this weekend. Kersbrook, Green, Thurston, Michael Salvin.
Balestre.
Dario Balestre, a current TQ at this point in time. The names of the drivers, the amount of people we spoke to, Timo Leino, Jules Groskamp, Sanders de Graaf, the IFMAR section chairman. There are so many people coming up in the next 45 minutes to speak to. Do not go anywhere. Seriously. We've got most of the Serpent roster for you. And whilst we just hide from the miserable weather conditions, you enjoy this second pit walk here on RC Racing TV. Our coverage presented by Team Shepherd, HPI Racing, Runner Time Fuel, and of course by IFMAR. Right, so welcome back to the IFMAR 110th IC Track World Championships. Here from, well, what was once the Gubbio racetrack in Italy, it is now a pond. It's a lake, effectively. Usefully, most of us, I mean, see, we have been out around the track. Getting a little bit damp, as you can kind of hear from up there. But this is a kind of exclusive look at our studio, at our setup. This is where we bring all the broadcasts in, both the computers, both the screens, timing, the setup, the visuals, the graphics over there, a little webcam there that was showing you the images. Window at the back there where rain's now coming in. Trying to shut that. There we go. It's that sort of day at this point in time, ladies and gentlemen. It is. The schedule's kind of gone out the window. There is rain kind of just pouring through here, and a lot of guys still aren't optimistic we'll get this thing restarted, but let's have a wander around and let's see what we can find. See if we can find, have a quick word with Ricky from Red RC. How, as the rain just picks up again, how how optimistic are you that we're going to get any more running today?
Well, looking at the track, there are a few puddles, so I want to say it's going to take like at least a couple hours, probably 3 hours. To if it stops raining to dry up, even if the sun comes out. So I'm not very optimistic for the rest of the day. I think it's game over for today, like 80%.
Yeah, and a lot of the people we've spoken to already are kind of in a similar boat. And to be honest with you, it was your forecast that kind of, it was your guys' forecast that predicted this. Like, well, I'm not saying it was just you that was just like, oh, yeah. This was the guy who brought the rain in. But please tell me it says better things for the next few days.
I'm just looking and it looks clear for the remaining of the week. So it's just today. It reports thunderstorms until midnight. So that's the forecast. It's not looking good for the day, but for the rest of the week should be all right. It will be interesting tomorrow in the morning because now the track has been washed out. So it's going to be like starting over with the, you know, with leaving tires on the track. It's going to be interesting to see tomorrow who's fastest.
For sure. Yeah, it is going to be interesting in that respect. We've had that conversation with a few drivers. We're going to talk to more of them about it. What do you think is the most likely plan of action going forward in terms of, will they try and complete round two or declare that a dud and go straight into round three? Because there was only the one heat left of round two.
Yeah, the problem is, to be fair, everybody should race in the same race condition.
Yeah,
so tomorrow's going to be cooler, but the track is going to be, I wouldn't say dirtier, because it's going to be washed out from everything the cars left on the track until now. So it wouldn't be fair to start again with the last heat of round two. I would say they'll cancel round two and start again with a brand new round, for sure.
And usefully in that respect, we've heard it quoted that as little as one round of qualifying can be run to make it official, but as long as they get a second round in, that should be good to go, right?
Yeah, that's how it should be.
Cool, okay, so if more weather turns up tomorrow, as long as we get another round of qualifying, we should be okay. Do we know what the situation is for Superpole in terms of weather?
In terms of weather, it should be fine because it should be run on dry anyways. So it should be all right.
But what happens if rain happens to turn up then? I think what I'm trying to ask.
I don't know. Honestly, Superpole is a new thing. I think it's only been introduced this year for the Euros. So there's no precedent. Like, I don't know. I really don't know what's going to happen if it rains like right during Super Bowl. Luckily, the forecast say won't. So
let's just hope that forecast holds. Otherwise, we'll be in completely unknown territory in that respect. Let's hope not. Let's hope the predictions are accurate and that we're good from here on out. Thanks very much for chatting to us. Let's hope for a dry rest of the week, shall we? Let's just move through here. More claps of thunder behind us. It ain't going away, folks. Not going our way anytime soon. But this is that was the media room we were just in, as well as our commentary booth. We descend these steps, which are all metal. I'm keenly aware of that, whilst lightning is coming down. So let's get Jean off that immediately. Let's move back through here. Let's kind of loop round through the pits. Frank is waving at me. Oh no, actually, I can show you a cool thing. What's this? Oh, it's locked. Hang on. Yeah, you see? Very big fans of that kind of security key card system here. It's kind of like Oyster cards. If you want to bring it back to a relative setting. Ah, here's a great guy to speak to here. And he's been very, very smart in terms of standing underneath some shelter. This is Michael Salvin. Now, first off, I'll just cut right to the point. How optimistic are you that we get back racing today?
Oh, I just checked the radar. It seems it dries up, but I'm not sure how much racing we will see. From the second round, we just missed the last group, and I heard that the rules state that they have to continue with that one, which means actually the fastest guy have the worst conditions. So that will mix up things pretty much. So wait and see, and it has to dry up. First, it has to stop raining, then it has to dry up. I mean, they can race even in when it's getting dark. They have good light and. Maybe they do it, I don't know. Otherwise, maybe they do an extra one tomorrow.
Yeah, I have a feeling. I think a lot of the guys I've spoken to, a lot of the other drivers have said it would almost be better if they can round two, go straight into round three, so it's an even setup. Is that how you're kind of feeling about it as well?
For me, that is common sense.
Yeah.
You know, but the rules are different. So, but a lot of rules are just stupid. So, I don't know. We will see. It would make sense to start with group one, round three, round the round, and then do the missing one somewhere in between when the conditions are similar to what they have been here.
Yeah, once you've kind of had guys out on the track who have kind of been the pioneers, if you will, and been like, okay, the conditions are fairly similar to where we were in round two, let's do that missing heat.
Yeah, exactly. I would see that as common sense, but you never know.
We're all in a bit of a world of unknown at this point in time, and that's what makes it kind of fascinating. The sun is actually poking through now. Yep. Let's observe. There's a brief bit of sunlight. Let's cherish it. But let's bring it back to yourself and to Team Serpent. How have you been? How pleased are you of the progress of the team so far this week, and how confident are you of the chances?
I'm really pleased. To be honest, we didn't expect to do so well. We had obviously Dominic is in the top most of the time, but now we have a really broad group of drivers that are doing the top 10 times and stuff. So I'm quite confident we will have a lot of cars in the final. But for the win, it will be really, really difficult. If you have seen the differences in lap times, it's incredible. I mean, the last one that just ended before it started raining, the first and the second guy were separated by 1,000ths. So this is ridiculous. So, but I think that it shows how good the rules are with the handout tires and the fuel and stuff. So it's really, really interesting, really close. We will see.
We will see. It's interesting you mentioned about the rules there, because there is obviously a control tire being used to this event, and there's generally a couple of gripes here and there about the tires, but generally so far, thoughts pretty good on it?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, there's always some moaning going on, you know.
It's race driver's excuses, you know, it's going to happen.
Yeah, exactly. But, you know, it's getting more difficult with excuses, because it's basically the same tire for everybody. You cannot make it absolutely the same for everybody, but my feeling is that the quality here of the tires is really consistent. It's probably not to everybody's liking, but I mean, come on, you know.
You're not going to please all the people all the time, are you?
No, you can't. You can't.
Well, let's hope that the track dries out now and we go through to the rest of the event, on to race day. How confident are you of Team Serpent bringing home the World Championship?
Oh, that's a tough question. we have a good chance. I think we have three drivers that could actually do it. And we have another two or three that could actually make the podium, I think. So we have a good chance. Let's say 50-50. You never know.
Nobody wants to hedge their bets too much, but some quiet optimism here in the Serpent camp from Michael Salmon. Good to hear from you, mate. And good luck for the rest of the weekend.
You too, guys.
And to be honest, it will make all of our jobs a lot easier if this dries out.
Yes.
Thanks very much for talking to us. The vastly experienced Michael Salmon here to have a word. And speaking of Team Serpent, here's one of his top drivers, the Brit Alex Thurston. And I'm just going to stand out here. Let's do this interview out in the sunshine.
Yep.
The sun on the track. This is remarkable. This is very much like being back in Britain. There's been storms for the last 2 hours, and now it's sun.
Yeah, I know. Hopefully it dries up a little bit. Hopefully it dries up. I had a good last round, so I think the rule is that they must continue with the round when it dries out, so fingers crossed I can have a good seed in the end. Get a good qualifying position.
Yeah, that's very true. Now, obviously, the conditions are going to be completely different, because as we can see here, the rain has been so much that it's kind of washed the track clean. What's your approach going to be for setup when you hit the track again? Is it going to be a case of try and anticipate how it's changed, or get some laps down and react to that?
For me personally, I think the best thing to do is sort of just try and revert sort of more to a similar British setup, realistically, because the wet will obviously make it more slippy, and in the UK we're used to low grip traction, so I think that's probably the best option at the minute until there's more cars circulated and the grip comes back up again.
Yeah, so I mean, there's been some talk about maybe running halfway through round three until the track kind of gets back to a similar condition, and then running the final heat of round two. Would that be sort of something you're in favour of?
Personally, I don't mind realistically, but I don't think I would like it if I was one of the earlier round three drivers, because they're the one with the disadvantage.
Yeah.
So I think it's just the same for everyone. If it's dry, it's dry, really. If it's going to rain all day, then we need to capitalise on when it's dry and not what the traction's like for everyone else. It's one of them things.
Yeah, there's a lot of playing by ear at this point in time with the conditions as they are, and they've really kind of thrown a lot of the established conventions out the window at this point in time. But let's bring it back to yourself, and let's bring it back to the rest of the event. Just how good are you feeling about your car and your setup and your chances of the becoming world champion going forward?
I think, well, realistically this year it's better than ever really, but I still don't think I've got enough experience personally yet to achieve that goal. But I mean, sure, I'm really happy. The first day we were here, like on the international practice, I was fifth, and now I'm running top 25 consistently, so never say never, but I'm at the moment it's looking like a lesser chance. But like I just said, it's never, you can never just go to the end and whatever happens happens, but it's still possible. Anything's possible at a big meeting like this.
Absolutely, and especially with conditions as they are, kind of a reset for everyone, it's could be a land of opportunity, you never know. But thanks very much for talking to us. Best of luck for the rest of the weekend. Let's just hope we get back running very soon, first up, before anything else happens. Right, I have just noticed, I think, if we just come through here, another one of the Serpent roster, there's plenty of them. Oh, hang on. Wait a minute, we're coming back. Oh! Ah! Before we chat to Mr. Greiner, we have Sanders de Graaf, the sector chairman for IFMAR for this event. Now, there's been a lot of questions, a lot of unknowns. I guess at this point you're playing a lot of stuff by ear. What kind of rough idea have you got for the procedure going forward? Will it be a case of trying to finish the round two or scrubbing that going into round three? What's the situation at the moment?
Well, the most important thing for the moment is that we get the track dry.
Of course, yeah.
The rules say if it starts raining we have to stop. And the rule also mentioning that, okay, if we continue we need a little bit more the same condition. Now, that's always, yeah, a little bit debatable, because you have seen it also in this round. You got sunshine and you got clouds before the sun, so also then the temperature drops, but at least we need a little bit of traction on the track. So in worst case, if we cannot finish or we cannot rerun or cannot start again today, simply because the track will be wet, then probably tomorrow we're going to start with round three, and perhaps halfway do the heat number 13 of round two.
So kind of let the first few heats of round three put some more grip back in the track, and then finish the last round. That seems to be quite a...
But okay, I have to talk also to the engineer jury because of that. It's not exactly written in the rules.
No. Yeah.
It only says, okay, condition must be similar and it must be dry. So, yeah.
And I guess a phrase like similar, well, how similar do you need it? Is it identical? Who knows?
Just what I say, also during a round, you can have sunshine, you can have clouds. So the temperature, I don't think is a discussion, but at least there need to be some grip on the track. So in the past, we have had this before, not only when we had, not only now because of the point system, but okay, we try to finish as much rounds as possible.
Mm.
That's the idea, and it should be a waste if we should say, okay, the first 12 each, we drop them, and we start over again. So, but okay, it will be probably a jury decision. So, but the first thing now, what we have to do is get the track dry, hopefully today. Otherwise, it will be tomorrow. It seems for tomorrow at least, there is no thunder and lightning expected or rain. So,
fingers crossed. The forecast is looking a lot better for tomorrow. And how optimistic are you that the guys here can get the thing dried up and we can get at least some running for the rest of the day?
Yeah, well, I think the most important thing is not only getting the puddles away, but we need sunshine and a little bit of wind. Otherwise, probably it will take too long. I think the latest somewhere around 4:30, between 4:30 and 5 o'clock, we need to make a decision whether to stop and cancel it for the rest of the day, or perhaps there is a possibility that we can run. So,
okie doke. So more of a kind of decision may well be reached around between 4 and 5 o'clock as to whether we get any more running in today. So, well, the guys are out there. They're doing their best. We understand you guys are doing your best as well. It's a very difficult situation for everyone. And we just hope that the weather cooperates a bit more with us so there's less difficult decisions to be made. But thanks very much for talking to us, Sanders.
Okay.
And good luck for the rest of the event. As I say, we'll hope we'll get this sorted out real soon. Let's head through here. The Serpent guys having a photo op through there. Good way of using the time. And then any. Aha! Frank has found another big name here. Mr. Jilles Groskamp. Good to speak to you. Probably not in the best circumstances, of course. You'd probably be wanting to be out there and the event actually happening. But for now, let's start off. How optimistic are you that we get any more running today out there?
I think it's 3:20 now. I don't think they can make another run today, because normally we, you know, we stop at 6 or 7 p.m. It's still really wet. Doesn't look really bright. So I think today is finished. Yes.
It's going to be very tricky, and there appears to be some questions over what happens next in terms of, do they attempt to run the final heat of round two or go straight into round three? What would kind of be your preference in terms of, or what do you think is the best way to go forward?
Of course, I was lucky enough that I was not in the fastest heat, but the heat just before. And yeah, for sure, we were lucky that we had a dry run, and I put in an okay run, finally. And I hope that will continue. But for sure, heat 13, they for sure gonna complain about it, because I think the track condition cannot be the same as before. Maybe they will open the track for free practice for some guys, and they can clean the track to make it a little bit more equal, more even. But I don't think you can never make the same track condition. So I hope that they won't skip the round. But honestly speaking, I think this is the only way they can do it if they want to do it fair. Mm. Yes.
So, I mean, it's interesting you mentioned that. You got a good run in round two. How do you feel your event's been going so far? You've been just beneath the top heat kind of pace. Presumably, there's still more to come from this car.
Yes. Just honestly, when we came here, we didn't have any expectations about the new car. But from like the first practice round, I was always there with Dominic and with Simon. And then, of course, later on, the guys who ran before, they started to practice on Sunday, and I was even competitive with Dario and some other guys who have been running here. But actually, only the last 2 days, the track condition changed. It got hotter, and for some reason, the car is not working the same. So we have to understand what to change now. Mm. So yeah, I was really, really, really happy the first 3 days of practice, and now we started to struggle, and now finally I got a little bit back where I wanted to be. Still not there, but still many, many races to go.
Of course. And what's going to be your attitude in terms of setting up the car now for, because the track's going to be very different in terms of cleaning the thing off. Is it going to be a case of trying to preempt what the track's going to behave like, or is it just a case of getting some laps down and then going, right, here's what we need to do?
Well, I think for sure the traction is it's going to be completely another story again. So maybe the traction will be back that it was when we started practice, when my car was good. So, but in that way, I won't go back to that setup. I think I will stick with the setup that I finished with. I will check other runs how they're doing, and I think I will just start with the same setup as I run before, and from there we have to see how's the track condition.
A lot of unknowns at this point in time. It seems to be that sort of event at the moment. But, I mean, the forecast at the moment is saying that the rest of the event is dry. Cross your fingers on that. And as we go forward, just how confident are you feeling that you can really challenge for the World Championship here? You said there's more to come from the car. You've been improving already. Do you think you got that the kind of extra 1% in there?
No, I must say in Thailand also, 2014, when I was battling for the win, with Alex, I also didn't start well. I was only 6 or 7 in the semi-final, and I just keep on changing my setup and try to, to make the best out of it. And then suddenly it just went perfectly. So now I have the same feeling. I'm a bit off the pace, but it's still qualification going on, and I'm trying things even in the qualification, because we have a new car. We have to. I also see this race as a test race. It's of course a world championship, and for me, I just try every round something different, just to see how it goes, because I feel like it can't go any worse. It can only get better. And I mean, I don't want to say that the car is bad now, but I feel like I can make it better. So I just use every round to try something, and hopefully we can put the cars in the semi-final. We can have a few guys in semi, like Andy and Jesse, doing really well at the moment. Hopefully I can also be straight in the semi-final, and then in the semi-final it's another game. It's a half hour semi-final, and when it's hot with engines here, it's very, very hard, and also tire wear is quite high. So even in semi-final, you know, you have the tire changes, and so it's a lot of things will happen.
A lot of variables going forward. And just one last thing, just talk us through a little bit of the new car. You see you brought it through here, it's a bit of a test race. What's kind of newer on it? What's kind of the big upgrades in terms of the chassis?
Our car now, our proto car, is the chassis and the bulkheads is Infinity. The yep. shocks are Infinity. But the rest is X-ray, Capricorn, Kyosho parts. That's mainly the parts that we use now because we didn't have enough time to make the plastic parts because you need a mold and this takes a lot more time. So it's completely new thing. Of course, it looks a bit same style as all the other cars. That was also our starting point, what we wanted to start with. But for sure, we gained a lot of information from the World Championship. And I think we will be back with a better, even better car.
So basically, the lesson to take out of this is, even if he doesn't get the World Championship this time, this will still be a big learning experience and be stronger long term in that respect.
Exactly. We are here with a big team. We have 9 cars running, and this is really really important because you get so much information. Yeah.
Excellent. Well, thanks very much, Yilis, for speaking to us. We hope you guys get back on track pretty soon. And I was going to shake your hand, but it's kind of full at the moment. With you. Okay. There we go. Right. Bit of elbow grease as well. It's all good. Thanks very much for talking to us. Right. There we go. Oh, we found another one of the most experienced guys here with Andy Moore, who we spoke to earlier. We now have Timu Lino. So how you doing?
Not too bad.
Probably not the best. This is not the right circumstance we wanted to speak to here. All sat under the awning trying to stay dry. But this was kind of anticipated to a degree. How likely did you think this was going to happen today, this big rain delay? Did you kind of anticipate it or play it by ear?
Yeah, I think already 2 days ago we checked the forecast and it said afternoon rain. And our Italian weather forecast guy said yesterday evening, 2 o'clock rain. Check, 2 o'clock, shower.
Now that is accurate reporting. We're used to in Britain like, oh, it may shower tomorrow, or it may be brilliant. Just find out for yourself. But that is really good accuracy on it. For now, I mean, I'll start off, simple question. Do you think we're going to get any more running out there today?
Nope.
Right, next question. But that's been the general consensus across. And what do you think will be the next step going forward in terms of, do you think it'll be a just run straight into round 3, attempt a final heat of round 2?
I don't know what they will do, but I think they should cancel the round because the last heat didn't try. So if they try after rain, it's no point. Maybe tomorrow, if it's dry, they could try 4 rounds. Start at 8 o'clock, finish 6:30, easy, 4 rounds. So I think that's the best thing.
That might actually be a very good strategy, actually. Just start earlier on, fly straight through, get all the qualifying rounds in. That might work very well. Now, let's talk about you in this fine-looking car here. How have you been feeling so far about your setup? Because you've not been quite where we expect you, but you've been just there or thereabouts. It feels like it's been about gradual improvement so far.
Yeah, we change the setup all the time because we test the new prototype, what we should do with the car. So every round it's up and down. And yesterday I was completely, I think the whole team when the sun came up was completely lost. Mm. But today, this morning, actually the car felt good and I was on a good run. I think I could have made 19 laps, but then the rear diff, the plastic gears, they broke. Okay, I thought it was the servo because it was feeling funny pulling one way. So we changed the electronics. Next round again, same story. Mechanics check, diff broken. Okay, change the diff and we tried and now it's working. But I think now we are more competitive. But today also the weather was different, so it depends how the weather is. We need to see when it's sunny again and hot. Are we still lost like yesterday? Yesterday it was very bad.
Just talk to us a little bit about that. Just how much did the temperature really have an effect on the setup? Because it was really hot and humid yesterday. Just what kind of effect did that have?
Yeah, the car starts to push always when it comes hot. So the traction goes away. So you need the more traction, more steering. Also the engines, it's more important because the high temperature, you see better which engine has power and torque than in cool weather. So it's both the car and the engine, the whole package, it changed a lot.
So a lot going through, and this is I assume this is a very similar new kind of chassis to your teammate Yiller's is running as well. Is that a very similar kind of new, slightly experimental setup?
Yeah, it's same chassis. We all use the same chassis. Everybody try different setups, and then hopefully end of the week we see if we get improvement. But still, we never test the car before come here, so we don't expect anything. It's just for a test race. Which sounds stupid, it's the championships, but for us it's more testing. So
well, I'll tell you what, if it works right out of the box in a world championship, you know you've got something really good. So I kind of admire that bold strategy. And thanks very much for talking to us, Timu. Best of luck for the rest of the event. We hope to see you up there real soon. And I think Frank's found us some more people. Yes, he's found Dominic Greiner. Mr. Greiner, welcome. How are you doing? Well, it's obviously not ideal. You'd rather be out there at this point in time, but... how does this kind of change the strategy for the whole weekend? I guess now what qualifying we do get in is of the utmost importance.
Yeah, now it's a very difficult the conditions. I think we had rain the first day and the second day in the morning, but we already had not the traction and the grip from now on. So I think we must change the car a little bit for the next qualifications, and also the tire wear is, I think, not the same as before. So yeah, will be interesting for the next runs.
Indeed. I mean, you've been right up there for most of the practice session. You've been right there or thereabouts. How confident are you of going all the way in this one? I mean, I know that's a very bold question to ask, but how confident are you in the car and how good are you feeling about it so far?
Yeah, we were on top on the timesheets the first 2 days, and the car feels pretty good on cold conditions, what I mean cold, 20 degree. In hot conditions, we had a little bit of problems, but overall now the setup was very good. Also, the first run today in the morning, I struggled a bit with my driving and the engine setting was a bit too rich, but overall okay, and fourth place for the first run is okay. But it's very, very close racing here, and I will do my best, and we will see what happens.
We'll see what happens, how it comes out there. Now, the Serpent guys have been very confident. I spoke to Michael Salvin earlier. He reckons you're probably leading the charge. You're one of several guys who could go all the way here. How cool has it been being involved with Team Serpent and under his sort of tutelage so far?
Yeah, the teamwork in the team is perfect. Our car, we made good improvements for this race. Also, our new parts that we're using here, very, very good. And we can see that every Serpent car in the top 10 can make the race. And
that's got to give you a lot of confidence. And one last question. Now, obviously, the rain has been so strong, it's kind of swept the track clean. What's your approach going to be in terms of setup when you next go out there?
I think, the tractioner, especially the differential, maybe we should change it to have more tractioner on throttle. And I think it will be more steering. We had more traction with more the grip on the track, we had more rear grip. So I think we have now more steering, what's better for all. But especially my car was better in the first 2 days. So I think it could be good,
So it might actually work out. For some, you may see disaster. For others, it's the opportunity. So thank you very much, Dominic, for speaking to us. Best of luck for the rest of the event. It's been a pleasure. Right. See if we can squeeze through. I think we found the dynamic Swiss duo of Silvio Hackler and 1/8 world champion Simon Kurzweg. Let's speak to Silvio first. Hi. Good to speak to you. Probably not the most ideal of circumstances. Rain coming down. It doesn't. Of most of the people I spoke to, they're not very optimistic this is going to get going. Do you think we're going to be out there again today?
I don't think so. For today, I think it's gone, but we'll see. Tomorrow should be fine, so we can make one more tomorrow. I think no problem.
Well, you've been in two rounds so far. Yeah. One of them may well be scrubbed off. Who knows what the fate of round two. But how have you been feeling about the car so far and your own speed?
Yeah, to be honest, my car is not that good as it is normally in 1/8. Because, it's my first race with Shepherd 1/10 scale. And, I learn every day, every turn I make. So, I have to learn more about the car and to improve my setup. But, I'm confident for the finals.
Well, I was going to say, we were there in Sweden not long ago in the 1/8 Euros, where you were right there or thereabouts. You were in the Super Bowl, really on the pace. Is it just a case of not being as experienced in 1/10 or a new team environment, just taking a little bit quicker to sort of gel?
Yeah, I think it's that I'm not often driving 1/10 scale. I was testing 3 days in Leno with Simon, and I also tried his setup here, but it didn't work in my car. Yeah, I have to find my own setup to feel confident and yeah, to be fast.
Okay, so case of kind of differing driving styles coming into play, I guess.
Yeah, can be. I don't think so. It was a little bit, strange that it didn't work in my car because I had really no steering with his setup. So yeah, we have to learn about that.
It's fascinating how much things can differ between teammates and that, but how useful has it been to have Simon to kind of bounce ideas off of and a bit of experience in that regard?
I don't understand.
In terms of like as having him as a teammate, how useful has that been in terms of advice and, you know, setup tips and things?
Yeah, it's very useful because yeah, he's always very fast and he has, I think, 3 or 4 years experience with the Shepherd car, so yeah, he knows what to do. Yeah, now I have to find a good setup for my driving style, and yeah.
It's kind of a voyage into the unknown now for this setup. But just one more question for you. The rain has obviously, it's been very heavy. It will likely have swept the track kind of completely clean. How do you anticipate it's going to handle when you next go out there?
Yeah, it will be very hot, tough, because they told that they will restart with the group where they stopped before the rain. So it should start with group 13 now. But yeah, now it's, I don't know what to do now, because yeah, maybe the best would be 15 minutes of free practice, but then everyone wants to go out. Yeah, yeah, will be a difficult decision for everyone here, I think.
I'll tell you what, it really is right now a voyage of discovery for everyone involved. There's drivers, there's teams, there's officials who are still trying to kind of work things out and get the best way through. But just one final question, how confident are you that you can find that extra bit of speed to go and win a world championship?
Yeah, I have 4 more qualification rounds, so I will try my best and I will try some things in the car to improve. I think chance is 50-50 that I find something. Yeah.
I like the fact most of the drivers, we ask about their chance, they say 50-50, you don't want to jinx it. I kind of appreciate that, but we're pretty confident you're going to be up at the sharp end in no time at all. Thanks very much for speaking to us, Silvio. Best of luck for the rest of the tournament. Now, just wondering, can we squeeze a little word in with our reigning 1/8 world champion, Simon Kersberg? Yes, we can. Hello. Yes. Obviously not ideal circumstances to be speaking to you. You'd much rather be on the track right now. But how does this kind of change your game plan going forward? Because obviously the rain is going to really change the conditions on the track.
I can't say how the conditions are now, but yeah, we will see how we start the race again. Maybe they start with group 13, or maybe we start or we cancel this round and start from new. I don't know yet. So, but also, at the first days, the grip level was lower, and we also there we were competitive. So, we will see how what happened. Yeah.
Just a general sort of thing. I mean, in both 1/8 and 1/10, you've been hugely competitive. Of course, you're the 1/8 world champion at this point in time. We were there last year in the 1/10 Euros. You were right up there, and now again, is it just something about 1/8 and 1/10 that you just enjoy both classes? Because some people say there's big differences between the two.
Yeah, sure. 1/8 is my favorite class. Also, I drive normally only this class, but sure, for the bigger events, it's really nice also to work with the team, with Dirk, Patrick, and all the other Shepherd guys, and it's really fun to be here, also with 1/10.
Now, I've got to ask you that. I don't like putting drivers on the spot like this. How confident are you that you can add a 1/10 World Championship to your 1/8 crown?
Yeah, I'm really confident at the moment because yeah, I'm in second position. Yesterday we were on 7th, so it's an improvement to yesterday, and yeah, we are happy. Now we have one safe run and we can go for more.
Very confident in very high spirits. He's strong in both classes. This is Simon Kersberg, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks very much
for speaking
to us.
Thank you.
Best of luck for the rest of the weekend. Right, I think Frank has found some people. Hello, who have we got here? Mark Green. Okay.
He's in the next heat.
Yep. Well, here's a guy who was about to go out on the track when the rain came down and then the British weather turned up. We thought we'd left this at home, Mark Green.
No, I unpacked it out of my suitcase.
Was it a tactical thing where you're like, I'm going to slip a banana skin under these guys?
Yeah, probably is. I fell over it myself.
So, one way of putting it, I guess. But to serious brass tack, if you will, the Serpent guys generally across the board have been pretty strong so far. How good have you been feeling about your car's setup so far? I feel like I'm at the Dartford Toll here, just kind of lifting the drawbridge.
Not quite in the right place here.
But see if we can squeeze back a little bit, actually. So Jean's less in the flow of traffic. Yeah, just how good have you been feeling about your own car's setup so far?
Pretty good, actually. It's been hot or cold on the track. Car's handled really well. The toughest thing is actually trying to make a good runtime with the engines, you know, safely, because you need to do 19. So you have to do those that split lap. So the first out lap, you have to take really easy to make sure you squeeze their line, you know. So, but other than that, it's been going really well. The car's been great.
Yeah, we were talking a bit on commentary when there were cars out on track, obviously, about that dilemma about making the 19 laps running fast enough but not running out of fuel. How hard a balance is that to strike?
Mostly it's down to temperature. In the mornings, it's easier because obviously the air is cooler and stuff like that, so you can lean on the engines a lot more. But when it starts to go up towards the 37, then it becomes real tough because you still have to look after the engine, you know, and I think that's when you'll see people struggling. But the temperatures haven't been anywhere near what everybody was expecting, so I think it's kind of helped everybody, to be honest.
Yeah, well, I mean, in terms of the rain, that's not a good thing, but in terms of the temperature coming down, might not be a bad thing. I mean, some people have really talked about how their car setup has kind of drastically changed. Like, they've been terrible in the cooler conditions, but really good in the warm. Do you think your car has just been... why do you think your car has been pretty good in all weathers? Is it just a good sort of one-size-fits-all setup?
No, for sure not. Because Dominic's setup to my setup is totally opposite ends, you know? Mm. But both cars are still working in the hot or cool weather. So I think it's just generic in our car that it is not so sensitive to temperatures.
Fast in all weathers. That could be a new marketing slogan. It could be.
Yeah, it could be.
Now, I mean, going forward, we're in a sort of world of unknown now. The track's going to be very different. How are you going to approach making setup changes? Are you going to sort of play a waiting game, kind of get some laps in and see what happens, see how different the track is or not? Are you going to try and anticipate some changes?
No, you don't need to. I mean, we arrived here, the track from day one, it's been pretty stable. So I think you have 5 or 6 heats ahead of us. That clean the track up and it'd be pretty much back to where it was. We don't need to do any changes, you know. You'll end up getting lost, you know, because you're changing the car to something that doesn't need to be changed.
You're making change after change, you sort of lose track of where it was that things...
Exactly.
Yeah, cool. Right, well, best of luck for the rest of the tournament. We're not saying that from a biased perspective at all. No. We are neutral, we're like the BBC, we're neutral, but thanks very much for talking
to
us. And best of luck. Cheers. Right. Has Frank found... He has. Yes, he has. More people have been found. Frank is in top form today. Who have we got now?
Dario.
Ah, Dario Balestri.
Yep.
Dario, I bet you're hoping that this rain doesn't end until at least the end of qualifying, because you're in a pretty good spot.
We already know about from the weather forecast that was rain today. Nothing changed. One hit we made was good for us. We are confident for tomorrow. Also, if the track will be still from the first day, then we restart from zero. But we are confident. Our car is good. I have a good feeling with my package. So we think to make another 2 good qualification.
Now, I mean, a lot of guys have been talking about how their car kind of handles better either in cooler or warmer conditions. Has that kind of affected you at all? Do you like prefer one set of conditions to the other?
Yeah. In my opinion, about my car, my setup is much better with hot condition. So also this morning when I saw from the track was cold, I was not so much confident, but anyway, it was good. For sure, if it will be more hot, I'm more confident.
So you're one of the guys hoping that the sun comes out again and really bursts down on the track.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you're right up there. You're the current TQ as it stands. You may well be... Well, I mean, how confident are you that we're going to get any more racing today? Because otherwise, you may well be TQ overnight.
I'm happy.
That's a great way of putting it, I guess. Now, you've obviously been quick in there, you're at the TQ at the moment. How confident are you of taking this 2016 World Championship?
I try to do my best. I prepared this race since 3 months. So we will see. for sure the key will be the engine, because when it gets hot, the engine win the race.
Mm. Well, I was going to say, some people have said attrition is going to be a big factor. Just how confident are you that your car can kind of last in all conditions? Because some people are saying that engines might, there's a risk of them blowing up in the finals, things like that. How confident that that's not going to happen to you? I mean, touch wood.
No, I try also in warm-up, and our engine with hot gets better. So we are super confident.
That's quite funny in a way, because a lot of people don't prefer the hot temperatures, but for Dario, it's all good. The hotter, the better. Well, thanks very much for talking to us, Dario. Yeah, let's hope that the sun comes back out for you. I mean,
we hope.
Best of luck for the rest of the tournament. Thank you. Right, well, now let's head back outside. Let's cut this one off. We have had a lot of time to chat to some of the best drivers in the world here in the pit lane and bump into some of the others as well. Quite literally, it's been that sort of day. And let's just move out here. Thank you very much, guys. And as we head back to the relative safety of our commentary booth, thanks very much for joining us here on RC Racing TV for this additional pit walk here from the IFMAR 1/10 IC Track World Championships. I'll see you again soon. Ah, yes. And while we're here, we can also enjoy some great views as well. So we're going to be looking out the window at them, because they're very nice. We're also going to be hiding from those, which aren't very nice. And we will see you again soon on RC Racing TV.